Johannes Hahn is Austria's veteran commissioner here in Brussels, about to enter his third term as a commissioner. He's been in charge of enlargement for the last 5 years, but under Ursula von der Leyen will take on responsibility for the union's budget at a time when it might come under severe pressure because of Brexit. Commissioner, thank you very much indeed for joining us. Given the fact that we may still be looking at a no-deal Brexit, how concerned are you about that and the impact it might have on the amount of money Europe will have over the next couple of years?
If it's a no-deal Brexit, it would have a very strong impact on the 2020 budget, because here we have still calculated with the UK, or at least with the situation which is agreed exit. So if this is not the case, we have to look into it and we have to adapt to the new challenges. But I'm still confident, like all of us, that finally we will have...
Have you looked at where those cuts will come?
My colleague and friend Günther Oettinger, who is still in charge, is certainly dealing with this issue, but it's too premature. And I think first we should do everything what we can do to avoid a hard Brexit. It's neither in the interest of us, the Europeans, and even less in the interest of the Brits.
But are we looking essentially over the next few years as either Europe spending less money or the wealthier countries contributing more money?
Well, that's up to the negotiations. Member States and the Parliament have to take the decisions, but I'm confident that by the end of the day, like always, we will find a good compromise.
Let's move on to the issue that has taken up most of your time over the last 5 years, this issue of enlargement of the European Union. It hasn't happened, really. In fact, if anything, it seems to have stalled with that veto in June to places like Albania joining. Were you disappointed? Is that a kind of personal failure of yours?
First, I mean, there was this famous statement of President Juncker at the beginning of our term in office that there won't be an enlargement during this term. But we have made a lot of progress in the last couple of years in terms of preparing countries more in order to become member of the Union. And in the case of, indeed, North Macedonia, Albania would have seen already green light for starting the negotiations, but I'm confident that this will happen now in October.
Can you assure that, you know, at some point in the not-too-distant future that they will be joining the European Union?
Now it's about starting, beginning with the negotiations, and today we have to see it as a process. It's not simply to negotiate the, so to say, takeover of our acquis communautaire, but it's about how this acquis communautaire is implemented.
Are we saying 5 years, 10 years?
No, it's up to the partner country. It's also about, for instance, in the case of Serbia, to align with the European foreign policy. It's about economic developments.
And you touched there on corruption, and under the definition of a job, it says that part of the responsibilities for the Commissioner for Enlargement are supporting pre-accession countries in implementing democratic and economic reforms and upholding the rule of law. Now, the nominee to take over your job was nominated by Viktor Orban and the Hungarian government. Do you think they're in a fit place to uphold the rule of law?
First, the candidate himself, I think he was a member of the Venice Commission, which is the most reputed institution in Europe and probably worldwide dealing with rule of law issues. Second, each of us, I mean, each commissioner has to give an oath to the European Union, its values, to the treaty, and has to be an European official.
Well, you can understand why lots of MEPs and others, yeah, are slightly concerned about this, that this is a country, Hungary, that is under investigation for own rule of law issues and now is expected to judge on accession countries. Do you understand those concerns?
I understand the concerns, but it's about an individual. The individual has to present himself in the European Parliament. There will be definitely a tough hearing. And afterwards, I think the MEPs should make up their minds and take the necessary decisions. But I am confident that the colleague will present himself in a very convincing way.
One of the new posts that Ursula von der Leyen has created, called Protecting Our European Way of Life. Do you understand what that means?
As a current commissioner, not only for enlargement, but also for the neighbourhood, I have learned how attractive Europe is, how attractive the European way of life is. In Europe, everybody can pursue his or her interests, freedom of expression, freedom of reassembling, etc.
But the current Commission President, your boss, Jean-Claude Juncker, told Euronews that he thinks it's a bad idea. Do you think that Ursula von der Leyen shouldn't change her mind on this?
I mean, she was presenting her program in early July. And exactly this, protecting the European way of life, was one of her, so to say, main areas, main topics. And nobody was discussing about it. Only a couple of days ago, it became a topic. And it was reduced to the question of migration. Migration and dealing with it is one of the many, many elements covered by this dossier. And to be honest, to offer asylum, to have a proper assessment procedure based on rule of law, also this is part of our European way of life. We have rule of law. We have standards where people can rely on
it. So it sounds like you think that she should stick by this title?
Of course, and I think we have to promote the European way of life. Yesterday in a debate amongst our new colleagues, I said, I remember when I was a child, a teen or a twin, we were really admiring the American way of life. I think since 20 years, nobody is talking about the American way of life, the American dream. Things have changed there. But I think we can be proud, we should be proud, and we should be more self-confident about the European way of life.
We looked at that picture of all of you the other day, and there is now gender equality, which I assume you welcome. But what there wasn't is just every single one of those commissioners was a white face. Is that not a bit embarrassing, almost shameful for the European Union, that there are no commissioners and never have been a commissioner that is non-white?
Well, not today, not in this commission, but it's not excluded that it will be in the future. It depends also
on the 2019.
It depends also on the political structure in our member states. Most important thing is, so to say, the quality, the expertise of candidates. And we should not differentiate. Is it somebody from this or this ethnic group? I think, indeed, Europe is colorful. Again, we should be proud of it. It's part of our European way of life, and therefore, I'm pretty confident that next time the picture might be much more colorful than today.
Commissioner, thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
Thank you.